guys. Marty Schwartz here from GuitarJams.com. Going to bring you a really fun song. Nice and groovy, makes you very happy, so to speak. And so I hope you dig it. It's not really a beginner song, and I do have the capo on the first fret. I'll explain it as we zoom in. Also, you can try all my lessons at GuitarJams.com. The website, there's a link right there. You can try the website out for free for 3 days. And I appreciate all that support, plus like the social media stuff's down there, you know, all that stuff. Anyway, let's zoom in though, and we'll break this one down right now. Here we go. All right, this is a really fun song. It's not really a beginner song, so if you're a beginner, it might be frustrating for you. So anyway, here we go. I put the capo on the first fret. There's a few reasons. One, we can kind of have the main chord be an E chord instead of a barred F chord. And then another reason is on the change, if I play the C major 7 shape, it's a nice easy voicing, it's nice and airy, and it works well for the tune. And I just kind of came up with this version myself. Okay, so check it out. So we're going to be grooving, right? We're doing this percussive, a lot of percussive thing on the guitar. It's not, you know, there's really not even any guitar in the original. So we're really changing, you know, the whole vibe, but... You know, I'm just trying to make it kind of like how I would feel that drum beat. And, you know, I've been playing guitar a long time, so I'm able to kind of like translate it into my own, you know, bag. Okay, so we got that. Okay, the other thing we're going to need is an E7. You know, we got the capo on the first fret, so it's really musically an F7, but we're looking at it as an E7 shape. Okay, so we got... I sound crazy, but So I'm still doing that grooving, and then there's some stuff going on here, right? So the bump, 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 that's all E7 shape. You know, you could add your pinky right there. But then on the bump, 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 it's probably going to work better to play like an E power chord. I'm muting that G string, as opposed to, but it's okay, you know, whatever you can do there, it's fine. I'm muting it, and I'm going like this, E, E, A, A, then a B. Musically, it's actually a C, but we're considering it a B because of the capo transposing it. That kind of bar chord there, that bar across, this bar across here. Back to the A. So watch. A. Beat the Scooby-Doo. So here it is slow. Really a piano song. So to make it sound that authentic on guitar, I did a couple of things. Here's what I did. I started with that C major 7 shape. So it's third, second, and then open. And that's really pretty. Okay. Then what I did was I went to this right here, so it'd be the first, second fret up from the capo, third fret, you know, without the capo. So we're barring that, and then playing a minor 7 shape, like an A minor 7 shape. So it'd be that. I'm just barring that G string there, so no finger on that, and then middle finger's on the B string. Okay? So it's like this. Then another, what I'm doing, and this is where I'm fudging the piano thing, I add my pink, you know, my middle finger just kind of comes off. My ring finger's in the same spot, and then I'm adding my pinky, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up from the capo. And without the capo, you know, playing it right there, that's a C suspended fourth. But it's right in that same bar. You got that minor 7 shape, then you add your pinky, then resolves to E major. Because I'm C major 7, E minor 7, we make it sus and E. Here it is. Hope you had some fun. It's a nice groovy song. I'm sure people will enjoy it if you play it for them. Also, I've got all those links down there. I really appreciate any kind of support you can give. Really appreciate that. And also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And also, I hope that I'll see you in another one of these videos real soon. All right, take care.